So we're going to talk a little bit about electric drives and the characteristics of the power sources that power them and how that affects the motor. So there are three basic ways an electric motor can be powered, and that's either by single phase AC, three phase AC, or DC. And here we show the voltage, but really the voltage waveforms and the current waveforms are more or less the same. So if we look at down here, we see DC power to the motor is constant. It never fluctuates. It's always exactly what your controller tells it to be. And that's really ideal because you want constant power to your motor. Conversely, we see single phase AC voltage and current here. And it goes from peak to neutral to peak to neutral to peak to neutral to peak to neutral to peak. So what's happening is the motor is getting power, and then it's not getting power, it's getting power, and then it's not getting power, and this is happening really fast. If in a 60 hertz system, you know, from peak to peak is going to be 120 peaks per second, but even so, in between all those peaks, there's also pauses in the power, so that's not ideal. Over here, we see our three-phase system, and we see kind of a complicated mess of peaks and valleys and neutrals, but what happens is the control system for this fires at 120 degrees. And what that effectively does is it makes it go like this. So each phase is only active for 120 degrees where it's peaking. So what you have is a whole bunch of peaks that form together something that's actually very similar to a flat line. And that's why three-phase power for motors is, you know, very desirable, because it acts a lot like DC. The power to the motor is more or less constant all the time, unlike single phase applications where it goes in and out and in and out. So let's look at some of the characteristics of an AC motor. AC motors have much less line losses than a DC motor, so that's really good. That means you can use smaller copper and, you know, your voltage, you'll have less voltage loss and less current loss, so that's great. The single phase motor, as we discussed, has relatively poor performance characteristics under heavy loads because of its fluctuating power nature. The three phase motor deals with heavy loads a lot better, especially if these heavy loads are startup loads, like an elevator where it needs a lot of power to even just get going. So AC power can be controlled by phase cutting. So an example like this is it would just take half of the wave. So it would take like this 50% of the wave, and then it would turn it off for this 50% of the wave. So it would only have half power, but it would be power that's going in and out. And that's the same with three phase. If you use phase cutting, it's not ideal because it can lead to a poor power factor in addition to poor performance. Another way around that, though, is a VFD, which can help smooth out the power because it converts the AC to DC back to AC, and so you can lose this power factor problem that phase cutting creates. And let's take a minute to look at DC characteristics. So DC motors have higher line losses than AC motors, so that's not a good thing. Constant power is always applied, which is great, especially for high startup load conditions. And if the power needs to be adjusted from the peak, it can use PWM, which means it just cuts this up into really fine pieces. So if you have switching circuits that operate at a high frequency, like 20,000 hertz or something like that, it's more or less invisible. There's no significant power ramifications for it, and there's no ramifications for the motor aside from the reduced power output that it has if you're looking to save power or whatever the reason may be. And then one last thing to consider is that the higher the voltage the motor is operated at, the smaller and more compact the motor can actually be. So in some cases that's relevant, in other cases it's not, but that is one benefit of running at a higher voltage level. Is that the motor can actually be smaller, as well as have less line losses due to decreased current.